Hello! Hello, what? And welcome to the official podcast. I am Andrew, professional sponge wrangler. Joining me on the couch, we have Jackson, wannabe wallaby. We have Charlie, strongman supreme and escaped mental convict. And we have Kaya, who some people don't believe actually exists.
Indeed.
There it
and
is.
Those names you can write on our tombstones, because today is the official podcast Pepper Parade. Yay.
Oh, that was cool.
Pepper Parade.
Pepper Parade.
The Pepper Parade. That
Pepper
was sly.
Parade. Like Pepper it. Parade sounds like a
We're
going
to eat
Disney
a bunch
cartoon.
Of peppers. Sponsored by everyone. Okay, let's...
Everyone introduce let's your peppers. Today I'm being
yes,
joined
by
jalapenos.
Yes, that's exactly what I was going to say. But before that, let's say hello to our friends over at VidMe. Now, if you want to know what VidMe is, basically take YouTube and rewind the clock on it back to when it was still run by humans. If you want a more personal atmosphere, you know, a website where you actually feel like you matter, and when you need help, you get the response you need, and you're not bombarded by ads on videos that you cannot even upload without being stricken by copyright suits and other such nonsense. Sense, you should give VidMe a try.
One cool thing about VidMe, if you are interested in checking it out, is they do not run ads. You will not find any ads on VidMe. Instead, you can directly tip and support content creators like you would see on similar websites such as Twitch. And hopefully that will make your viewing experience on VidMe even more pleasant, because you can check out the official podcast available on VidMe in the description below.
What are your peppers, Charlie?
I just introduced them, but I'll do it again for the grand reveal. I'm having jalapenos. I'm not accustomed to anything hot, so jalapenos are about my threshold of pain.
All right, Jackson.
I'm eating the delicious bird's eye pepper. It's hot.
Not even able to spell it out. Okay. Andrew, what do you got? You were bragging all before we started recording.
Yeah, let me tell you, hours and hours just... So I got some green ones, which I forgot the name, but most importantly, I've got some Scotch bonnets. This is gonna suck.
All right, how do those rank on the fucking?
Well, I went to my local supermarket, and they had a rating from 1 to 10, and they gave them a 10. So let's go.
The Scoville on the Scotch bonnets is 100 to 250k on the Scoville.
Scotch bonnets are up to 400k.
No, now you're just making shit up to try and seem cooler. They're 100 to 250k, as confirmed by Scoville himself.
Andrew, you do this every podcast. You just mention good things about yourself. We're all sick of it.
Yeah, I got it. Me and my tallness and my big pee-pee, it's gotta go. It's just dragging everyone down.
It's too much. What are you eating today, Kaya?
Well, these are some... I have a jar of unnamed little peppers that just look like little, as you called them, bird droppings. I also have a longer, more greenish and thin peppers. See, the problem is
where
in Turkey, every
that?
Pepper is called a pepper.
Where did you find the long green pepper, like on the side of the road? You made that sound like something you haggled off of a homeless man for a penny.
I mean, it's basically every market in Turkey, so yeah.
So you don't know what particular kind of pepper they are?
I do not, Jackson.
He sent me a picture of
them. I've said this like 10 times now. I live in a country that's not very, you know, concerned with details and such stuff as the Christmas Island.
Take that out of your can. Yeah, Christmas Island.
Christmas Island.
Yes, where we do not believe evolution is a thing anymore. So, unfortunately,
Kaya,
everything I eat today is classified as a pepper.
You're giving yourself
believe
away.
Me, yes.
You need to say you don't believe in Santa Claus anymore.
No, I know. Evolution is a lie. I know. Fuck. Why are there still monkeys if evolution is real? That's what I fucking thought.
Does Christmas Island believe in Santa?
No.
There's only one way to find out. We'll be at Christmas Island next episode.
Since Charlie is eating weak sauce and I'm probably eating weak sauce, I guess. I mean, Charlie's downside is he's never eaten hot stuff.
Yeah.
And my downside is that anything hot I eat, I immediately produce diarrhea. It just triggers my body. I know that technically it's not the peppers I'm shitting, because it cannot be going through my intestines in 5 minutes. But as soon as I eat anything hot, I'm on the toilet and... 5 minutes.
Aren't you also standing up right now to reduce pressure on your stomach?
Yeah, exactly, on my stomach. I am actually upright right now. And I'm already like hopped up on coffee and too much sugar. So this should probably get my breathing real going.
Let's
go. I get real close to the mic.
All right, Kaya, go ahead and eat your first candy corn pepper. I'll eat my jalapeno, my first one.
All right, God, this is a big one. I want a medium sized one.
I already ate mine, Kaya. Don't get so close to the mic. That's
yeah. These noises are what the viewers look for.
That's what. Oh my god.
Let's just have a whole podcast on.
They can, Andrew. They cannot fucking see us suffer. What do you want me to do?
So
they have to hear us.
These peppers were brought to us by the good folks at VidMe. VidMe is a platform to host your favorite cat videos on. So
yeah,
eat a pepper. Eat a pepper, guys. Everyone,
Charlie, are you ready?
Everyone?
Oh, all right.
Charlie. Yeah, Andrew, eat a pepper.
Everyone eat a pepper.
I like how now he's like arguing. No, wait. What, me?
God, are you serious?
Okay, Charlie, you ready?
Yeah, I just ate it.
Oh my god. Oh,
I hate when you make that. You like eat the mic.
There's nothing
with
I can do about
are
it.
Are we okay? So we're going. We're doing this, Jackson.
Uh huh.
Okay.
And we'll all be suffering fucking pain.
I'm fucking terrified.
Like to celebrate our first sponsor for the podcast, which is VidMe. Charlie, you want to talk about it?
Yeah, VidMe is a YouTube alternative with a very friendly UI. Our favorite channels on VidMe include the official podcast.
Not
there's
that
some other people
and
on there
channel.
Too. Yeah, Kai is on there. So
oh
we
my
got
God, this is
the oh, official. Oh fuck! Yeah. Yeah.
No,
Andrew
no,
just
I didn't
swallowed
mean
some
to
water.
Interrupt.
Yeah. So, oh no,
we're getting sponsors for the official podcast because we're trying to get enough money to get Kai out of Turkey. This is kind of like our Mission Impossible.
Oh, good God!
What are
I thought it would stop, but it hasn't.
No, those things linger, man.
Oh!
Jalapenos at least don't last that long.
Oh! Okay.
Charlie, just, I cannot, this is going downhill.
Oh, it's time for the end of the podcast. You need to hurry the fuck up.
I think Jackson's gone catatonic from
no.
the bird's eye.
No, no, no. Moving Andrew. On. Go do the pop. I can't talk.
All right. No, so our no, first question comes to VidMe. From VidMe. They ask,
who do you sponsor the most?
The pain gets worse. Let's fucking go.
I mean,
Andrew, which one did you take?
The Scotch Bonnet.
did you eat all of it?
Yes!
He blew his whole load right away. He heard VidMe and just
get
needed
close
to
the mic. Get close to the mic.
I just
want to hear you.
I just ate another jalapeno.
I'm not drinking water either.
Charlie, you need to tell me
before. They jalapenos taste so good, but they're really hot to me.
No, they're not!
So do mine.
So I'll Jackson,
okay,
are you,
just
can we go to the first viewer
yeah,
question?
Yeah, viewer questions, please, hurry.
Oh, before oh, Andrew goes into cardiac arrest
Jackson,
over there.
Jackson, did
yeah.
you take your pepper?
Yeah. It was yum.
Oh.
All right, I'm good. We're okay. Right. I'm okay. I'm sweating, but I'm okay.
Yeah.
I'm genuinely sweating.
Me too. All right, Jackson, go on with your first viewer question, which we take now for some reason.
All right.
Because I don't know how much longer Andrew's going to survive.
No, we're okay.
Yeah.
No, we're okay. I'm tough. We're good.
You sounded real tough there.
It fucking snuck up on me. It was like this wasn't so bad, and it just kept getting worse.
Don't be so loud. Your mother might come in concerned.
And then she'll kiss me and take all the hot away.
She'll just lick it out of your mouth.
I'm coming,
suck
son.
The poison, not like a snake poison thing.
All right, first question. First viewer question. How long until right. I going to drink at least water?
No.
No, dude.
The end
we're
of the
not,
fine. I'll hold out as long as I can.
Jackson, come on.
Nahaln asks, if you could go back to one event that took place in the past, whether you were part of it or not, which event would you go to?
I wouldn't eat this fucking pepper.
Yes, you would. You'd have to.
When it went, fuck.
That's a tough question that I'd have to think about.
Wait, go it back is. To the past and relive it or do it differently?
I guess just witness it?
Yeah, no, you don't have to be a part of the actual event, so you could just be an onlooker. I don't think you have any control over what happens.
I think witnessing the moon landing as it happened would be really powerful.
Oh yeah,
that would be really
like,
cool.
Like, do you
yeah.
mean on
the
moon,
moon
or like
yeah.
in the
either
NASA
either part
room.
Of the crew or part of the ship or even hell just someone watching it on TV as it happened.
Part of the ship, you're just
you
one of the
you should
legs.
Be on the moon as they land there.
Just like, "Hey guys."
You beat them to it.
Just hey, you guys want to eat some of these Scotch bonnets I brought? Whew, okay. Whew, it's dying down
Charlie,
a little bit.
Popping another one.
What's up? Another one?
Yeah.
Yours cannot be that hot if you're so eager for more peppers.
Yeah. I'm eager for pain.
Kai is eating chocolate.
There you go.
May I remind you, pain is my kink.
Oh,
I like
fuck.
This.
Oh, I'm sweating. Right,
I'll have another one. Whatever.
All right, we'll eat another pepper.
Oh, my God. No, I need a minute. I can't do another. I need a minute.
Jackson hasn't even proven to us that he even has peppers.
I'm eating it right now.
That could just be a sandwich. Yeah,
Jackson,
I could do that, too.
Make a disgusting sound, Jackson. I want to hear the sonic signature of a pepper.
Jackson, you answer the question now.
Oh, my
answer
God.
The question
a photo
now.
Of it?
Oh, my fucking God. Oh, it burns my chest. It's burning my fucking chest. Ask the next viewer question, please.
No, I want to answer this.
We didn't even answer the question.
I'm
you
sorry.
You just said you'd like to
Time is moving at like time is moving at 80 miles an hour right now.
Let's go. Answer.
I'm actually shaking.
Jackson.
What? Really? From jalapenos?
Oh, yeah. Oh, from jalapenos. Oh, he's got the pussy penos over there. That's the guy that's in pain.
I was just genuinely trying to ask.
Jackson, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm dying. Fuck.
Well, answer the question and then die.
All right, I'd go back to the extinction period where the dinosaurs died.
Where the meteor hit them.
I know, this is hot.
Guys, my nose is running.
Join the club, man. I've been wiping my nose this whole time.
Oh, fuck. Oh, I'm crying. A little bit.
Felt like a bitch.
No, it's dying down. It's dying down.
What would you go back and watch, Kaya?
I don't know. Either Hitler's suicide or the moment Saddam took power. Sounds like cool shit.
Anyone's thinking serious stuff?
Very conflicting.
I mean, it's not serious stuff. It would be just really interesting from a historic perspective.
Charlie, are your nipples hard too?
Yeah, I keep getting like goosebumps.
Mine are diamonds.
Yeah, mine have gotten really erect.
Charlie, what period would you go back to?
Is it what period or what event?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's
either.
Event.
I guess it'd
probably
go back.
Not that moment he got beaten speedrunning.
I'd probably go back to when Socrates was discovering like buoyancy when he just laid in the bathtub. Just to see like the epiphany he'd have from laying in a fucking bathtub would be kind of cool to see.
Oh.
That was Socrates, right?
My mouth is really hot.
Oh my god, my tongue is burning.
My actual stomach is like heavy and warm, and
hey,
I hate
Andrew,
it. Yeah.
Andrew, last week you were going to tell the first time we had sex. Let's hear that story.
Okay, great. So the first time I had sex, do you want to start or should I start? I don't know whose story is longer or more interesting.
You start, but take a pepper.
All right, okay. So the first time I had sex...
No, you didn't eat a pepper. The story's stupid without a pepper.
I'm gonna take a bite. So the green ones are big. I'm going to take a bite of the green one. How about that?
That's okay. All right.
Oh,
God. Okay. All right, little nibble. Here we go.
No, not a little nibble. You said a bite.
No, like a substantial nibble. Substantial nibble.
Okay, here we go. Please pussy and just shove it in your mouth.
Okay. That's the crunch of the pepper. I'm eating it. Okay. Jackson, lower our audio levels if we're chewing obnoxiously.
No, that's the whole point.
Okay.
They need to hear that we're eating.
Okay, I swallowed the pepper. So, as the flavor is creeping back into my mouth, when I was 17, my girlfriend at the time was 24.
What, Tom?
No. So when I was 17, my girlfriend at the time was 24, and I met her on the internet because I was a hip happening teenager with tons of friends. And by that, I mean I had no friends. And as this pepper is getting hotter... Okay, sorry. So I met her on the internet and we met in person and she like flew down to Florida to meet me. And she stayed at a hotel across the street from my parents' house because I was a little baby boy and I felt awkward having sex in my parents' house.
Did you order an escort?
So no, she was my girlfriend.
Russian bride.
We internet dated for 2 years. Or like how,
what does internet dating consist of? What do you do for dates?
Webcamming, talking on Messenger, sending
AIM.
Nudes. Yeah.
No, there's no nudes to be sent there.
Of course.
Not as a 17-year-old boy.
Well, yeah, of course, but you get the point.
Stay clean.
So
kids.
Eventually we went to the hotel and she was a disgusting and terrible person, but I was 17, so I didn't care. I was like, does your vagina work? All right, let's go.
Did you inspect it? Did you inspect it first? Did you put a pepper in there?
I mean, as a 17-year-old, I looked at it at one point and went, oh, okay. Like, I don't know.
Well, that's not a very thorough examination. You'd be a horrible gynecologist.
Someone, Satan is like vice gripping the back of my throat right now. So, so we went to the hotel room and we had sex, and she was on her period at the time because timing is bad.
Oh my god.
Oh, okay, sorry.
That's something you could have ruled out if you had just put a scotch bonnet in there.
No, what?
Yeah, that lets you know if they're menstruating or not.
Yeah, just for people who want romance advice at home, shove a scotch bonnet in her pussy. You'll get some fiery afterbirth. Oh, fuck. Ow. Okay. So we went to the hotel room, and she was on her period, and she had like one of those like anti-period things in her vagina. I don't know. Like, I guess a diaphragm. I don't know.
Tampon.
No. No. And it was just, I don't know if she didn't put it in right or if it like got in the way.
You made it sound like a military weapon.
What are you talking about?
But the point is that
was
like,
she like MacGyver?
The point is that in my
battery.
Andrew's just out of it right now.
The point is
an anti fucking
sound like a broken Furby.
Because how do I counteract these arguments when speaking hurts?
It's not
discombobulated, completely disoriented.
It's not an argument. You just made it sound like some type of experimental weapon.
No, it was like it was like a thing.
It's a tampon.
It wasn't a fucking tampon, Jackson.
What the fuck was it?
I don't know.
Are you talking about a menstrual cup? Yes or no? Are you alive?
What?
And are you talking about a menstrual cup?
What? Oh, probably. Yes.
Okay. Well,
I prefer.
I'm sorry. I don't know all the tools. I didn't even say what it is. Vessel. And you guys are all like, oh, was it a probe? Was it a fucking corn husk? Did you pull it out and lick it? Yum, yum, yum. Like,
no,
I don't
one
know.
Said that.
Andrew.
What?
Andrew.
What?
Andrew, you're way too eloquent again. Take another bite.
He's lucid.
Fine. So anyway, so she put in the cup and we started doing it. And now later in my life when I had actual sex with people who weighed under 200 pounds and people with actual personalities and skill, I realized
what skill does it take to just receive a penis? Is that really like an ability that you cannot have?
I realized that she was bad at giving blowjobs too, and also bad in bed. She was like, just lie there and be awkward. So anyway, though, at the time, my 17...
she just keeps dodging the dick like
my 17
target.
Charlie, you've obviously never slept with good people then, because once you do, you realize how bad people are.
He's not wrong.
So then
I mean,
I realized
some are better than others, but
so anyway,
just to say that
to wrap this story up, because this is nothing.
You just touched my eye.
I was a loser, and she was 24, and she was bad in bed, and the end.
24. What about the anti period device? What was the fate of that?
She threw it in the fucking garbage. I don't know.
You should have reclaimed that, man. That was some alien tech up there preventing periods from the inside.
Did you have any blood on your wiener?
Yeah.
I have blood in my mouth.
Wait, did you use a condom, Andrew? Were you a smart boy?
Of course.
Okay, good boy.
He wrapped it in capucin.
Oh my fuck. Oh god. I might have to tap out.
He wrapped it in nanoshield technology.
I might have to tap out.
Anti-sex device.
My mouth is numb. I might have to give
up. No tapping out. Oh, my eyes are burning.
No, I can't feel my mouth.
Did you just pepper spray yourself?
No, the thing is, this whole jar is filled with juice too, so I
yeah,
get
so
my
is
hand
mine.
In it too. Yeah, and I got my eyes with that juice. Like an idiot, now I have to hold them close.
Are you alright, Andrew, for real?
Huh? He's dead. Did he die?
Fuck, man, I cannot open my eyes.
Wait, what happened to
Charlie?
Andrew?
Huh?
Are you okay over there?
I'm in a lot of pain.
Drink some milk.
No.
While you drink milk.
No milk.
Try,
no,
Kai,
no
said,
milk.
I can feel
no
a burning sensation in my
no
ears.
It's legitimately like melting his brain.
Oh no.
No pain.
This sucks.
Think of Rocky IV, no pain.
This sucks so much more than I thought it would.
Alright, I'm gonna get a
Charlie,
pain,
is your
Charlie,
first
you're
time
getting
funny.
Milk?
No, I'm getting a jalapeno.
Oh, okay, good.
Do you want to wash down your scotch bonnet with some of my jalapenos?
I want to wash down this pain with a bullet. But before that, I have been elected by tribal council, and by that I mean I stepped up and decided to do it, to mention once again that we are graciously sponsored by the people at VidMe,
yeah,
which is a different, eclectic take on video websites using Reddit-like voting features to get the content you actually want to see and not any of that fluff recommended garbage. And in fact, one cool thing about VidMe is they do not use ads. They do not use advertisements. Instead, they directly allow tipping to the content creators so you can support the videos you want to see and, you know, roundabout, get more videos like that. And if you're listening this far into the podcast, I'm guessing you like to see the official podcast, which you can now also watch on VidMe. So go over there and take care of these cool fucking features.
Check it out.
Yeah, why not? Yeah. Fuck it.
The link's in the description.
There you go.
My eye. This isn't, like, harmful for eyes, is it?
Yeah, it is. It's actually really bad to get it in any mucous membranes.
Oh, wonderful.
My teeth are vibrating! Guys, I legit have to drink... I have to, like, tap out in some way. I'm actually
drink
in
milk.
Pain. I have
yeah,
to.
Just drink milk. My head's getting
hot. I'll be back. I'm gonna get some milk.
I thought... Didn't you have, like, a gallon of milk next to you?
Whose idea was it to do a fucking chili challenge on the first fucking sponsored episode?
It was mine. What? Kai and I came up with it.
What?
Did you, like, what did you do? Clean your ears out now with the fucking...
No, I got my phone so I could take a picture of myself squinting and crying. What were you talking about?
He wants to relive it later.
Really, nothing.
Really
relive
do love
what
pain.
Later?
Alright, Kai, how about you?
Hang on, oh my god, I'm legitimately fucking crying right now.
So to sum it up, please go check out vidme.com. We're on there, so go check out the official podcast on there. We'd really appreciate it. Thank you to VidMe for sponsoring our episode. We really appreciate it.
Yeah, they'll probably never do that again. Oh, we're not sponsoring the chili people again, the pepper boys. I'm having a lot of fun. Jackson's been very quiet, though.
I don't have a fucking in. Andrew's fucking crying constantly. Kai is muttering something in Turkish, and Charlie's constantly talking about VidMe. What do you want me to do?
Andrew, meanwhile.
These were hotter than I thought it would be. It says medium on it.
Holy shit, it says medium on a bird's eye. Those things are 100 to 225K Scoville.
Yep.
Yeah, that sounds about right for medium. Oh, man, I feel good. This is giving me some energy. Jackson, what's our next topic?
There's a beautiful picture for you boys.
I'll throw that up on the video.
I was able to hold my eyes open for 1 second. You guys better appreciate it.
You look like an 8-year-old boy that just walked in on his parents having sex.
No, I look like an 8-year-old who was just beat with a pepper. Like fucking pepper knocks.
Oh, God.
Let's take bets on how long it'll take Andrew to come back.
He's probably collapsed by his fridge.
Fucking chalk outline.
And apparently he has to cross the desert between his couch and the fridge.
Yeah, the distance between his room and the fridge is unparalleled. It's like a fucking nomadic journey.
In the meantime, Jackson hit us with a question.
No, Charlie, yeah. do you want to tell your story about how you lost your virginity?
I mean, oh, there's Andrew. He just sent a picture. But yeah, I'll do...
Oh, boy.
Oh, man.
Did he know? Hang on, baby.
It seems the pepper broke his thumb. I'll throw that image up there as well, otherwise people won't know what we're talking about. If you're listening to the audio version of this podcast, head on over to vidme.com, to the official podcast channel, and check out the video version so you can see what Andrew's thumb looks like.
So, I want you to also take note in that photo. The complete redness of my lips, the paleness of my face, and that white spot on my forehead is a literal pool of sweat.
Yeah, man, it looks like you just worked out.
Oh my god. So, the milk, I drank a half gallon. It still hurts a lot, but it's tolerable, and when I don't talk, yeah, it doesn't hurt.
So, who's left for this, this pepper paradise we've got going on here?
What do you mean, who's left?
Well, Andrew's done.
Is this a hit list?
Oh, whoa. I might hop back in. I need a breather, though.
Yeah. I don't think it'd be wise, Andrew.
Oh, you mean as in tap out?
Yeah.
No one's tapping out.
But I'm in the ring.
Well, Andrew said like 6 different times, guys, I'm going to have to tap out. Guys, I'm done.
Well, okay.
Okay. Guys. Oh, well, I ate a whole Scotch bonnet followed by a like 100,000 Scoville, half of that. So yeah, cut me some slack. I might jump back in, but I need a breather.
No, it's respectable.
Oh, God damn it.
These explode.
This was the worst idea ever.
This is a fantastic podcast. Thanks for tuning in to the official Pepper podcast.
The Pepper Parade. Kaya, you look like someone told you your dog just died.
Oh, yeah, that look. I know. Fuck me.
Oh my God, I can feel it in my
Jackson
dick.
Questions.
No, so, Charlie's going to talk about his virginity.
Yeah, Charlie, talk about your
fuck,
virginity.
You really fixated on Charlie's dick.
Yeah. Well, yeah. How old were you when you lost your virginity, Charlie?
19.
Wow. Really?
Yeah, no. Yeah.
Late bloomer.
Kid Jackson's like, I still got a chance.
How much?
I was
like,
16.
What if I drank this entire thing of jalapenos, like juice and all? I'd probably die.
Don't. That's what I've been thinking, but if you do, I will have to honor code, and I don't
want to. Yeah, I don't want to either. But yeah, if you want me to talk...
hardcore.
Yeah, that's really fucking... That's some Chili Klaus level shit right there. But if you want me to talk about that, I will. Or we can go to another question. The story's not that interesting.
Talk about it. Your fans
please
like
talk
it.
About it before I shit my fucking ass out.
It's legitimately not that long, though, is it?
It's not that long. I'll just talk about it quickly.
You can talk about the technique she used.
The technique she used.
Jeez. Jackson, I feel like you have an ulterior motive here.
Give her
He's
a rating scale.
Off.
I was trying to learn to become a better lover for Charlie.
What did you like about what she did?
Well, no, that's an actual question. What's a sexual technique that you prefer, Charlie? Please go first, and then we'll move on.
Sexual, you mean position?
Or anything. No, dude, do girls not do stuff for you?
It sounds like they just starfish
It
for
sounds, them. Honestly, for like having good sex sounds foreign to you.
How so?
Like,
what do you mean by fucking technique? Like, when they jiu-jitsu, Brazilian jiu-jitsu,
when they
taekwondo?
Suck your wee-wee, do they, like, go the extra mile, or do they just go, all right, put it in my mouth?
Do they solve the Chinese puzzle box and summon the fucking Xenobites to please you and show you worlds of pain?
And pleasure.
Yeah, finally someone got that.
Dude, I know exactly what that's from. What are you talking
about? That's the first time anyone's picked up on a
Hellraiser. Yeah, obviously you never picked up on it.
That was a rough one.
That was his freestyle rap about the movie.
I'm just fucking repeating things now. The jalapeno's getting to me.
Oh my God. That that was so unpleasant.
Charlie,
tell your story.
Okay.
Charlie, hang on. Do me a favor.
Yeah.
Dip your hands in the sauce and just smear your eyes with it.
Charlie, do me a favor. Just dip your dick in the jar and stir it around a bit.
Yeah, I'll pass on both.
Come on, Charlie. We said we'd do everything
no,
together.
No, Charlie, for real. Actually,
BFF promise.
Yours was a fucking accident. I'm not gonna fucking wipe my eyes with the pepper juice
you,
like a
you don't
kabuki.
Know
Charlie,
why.
Drink some of the juice for real. I actually want you to do that. Drink a little
I
bit.
I really don't want to drink any of the
no,
juice.
No, come on.
You have to, Charlie.
Drink the juice.
It's the seed
I'll
that's
take a
the
sip.
Spicy part.
Charlie, I'm not a, you know, honor code dismissing goober like you, so if you drink all the drink.
Oh, wow, the juice tasted really good. It's not even hot.
Nice.
I said it. It's the seed
that's jalapeno
spicy
flavor.
Yeah, no, the juice wasn't hot at all.
I mean, isn't a pepper's hotness like the self-defense mechanism so it doesn't get eaten by shit? So the seed
Yeah, but then it made it super tasty and the like blunt of all these challenges. So.
That's a really shitty self-defense mechanism. By the time it activates, it's already dead.
Well, no, the idea is that so it wants to procreate and the seeds are spicy. So when the animal eats the seeds, it doesn't eat any more because they're spicy.
That's clever.
Yeah, that's the idea. But don't also some fruits use that to their advantage so the animal eats them and then shits them out in different spots?
There's plenty of different ways seeds get around.
Biology boys, that's why you tune into the official podcast.
The official biology pepper podcast.
Biology, pepper biology. That should be a class.
I feel like a marching parade fucking stamped on my liver. There's this weird, weird specific pit in like my stomach area. I can't describe it, but there's just this like fucking
You might have gotten stabbed.
Diuretic feeling there and
alcohol
it won't leave. No. Speaking of which, peppers, it's just alcohol. The drunk podcast needs to happen at some point.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, yeah. That'll be a lot of fun.
Do a shot for every question.
Oh, that'd be good. Yeah. So, Charlie, please tell your story. You've wasted enough time.
All right. I was so at 19. It was right before
critiqued by Andrew.
Right before spring break. I went to a bar slash club type deal, and I did my typical, you know, busting it wide open of moves, which caught the attention of a potential mate. And then we just started
fireball shots.
Did you use your spicy seeds to ward off her predators?
Yeah, I just sprinkled seeds around her so no one would come close.
Nobody better eat near my girl.
Screwed up pepper sprays him. He was about to rape you, sneaking up on you.
That was my boyfriend.
No,
it wasn't.
I wish that pepper spray joke you made it into here. That was so fucking funny.
It's all right for everyone Please. Listening. The plan was I was gonna pepper spray myself, but we'll save that for episode 10, I guess. I can get some.
Charlie, the 1 year continue. Anniversary. Yeah. So one thing led to another. We started talking, then we just went back to my dorm, and I ripped some more shots because I was like, I'm gonna need confidence because I was an insecure little boy. And then we fucked, but I didn't really know what it meant to fuck. I didn't realize that there was a sweet spot of time, like of 20 to 30 minutes. So I went for 2.5 hours without coming. And then she was just in pain. It became like a challenge for her.
And then like a rabid dog or something.
She pulled out a stopwatch and was like, keep going, tiger.
We're approaching world record. But yeah, so then I'm
drooling and snarling.
Isn't that whiskey dick?
I don't know.
Actually, Charlie, if you were drinking, you might have had whiskey dick.
Yeah, probably. So did. Yeah, just fucked
I
for like 2.5 hours.
You specifically telling me you drank just to have whiskey dick. I remember the story.
Oh, that's cute.
You were playing League of Legends.
Did I?
You
I
might
don't
have
remember.
Overdone it. Might have paralyzed your dick.
Yeah. I mean, it still got nice and hard for me, a good little soldier.
I remember her getting frustrated at you for not coming, and her asking you if there's something wrong with you.
Well, she did inquire, but yeah, I ripped like 2 condoms, and then I went to my buddy's stash, ripped another one, and then she just said, "Let's be done." And I was like, "That's probably a good idea."
Let's be done.
That's a happy end. Let's be done.
I mean, she slept over. She spent the night.
Oh, she didn't away?
No, she didn't run away.
What? Oh.
But yeah, that
did,
was
did you make
story.
Did you make her come at least once?
Probably, I don't know.
I didn't ask. Was really eager.
Yeah, but what about the gland-to-gland combat? Was there a lot of juice?
That's a relevant question. Did she come?
I think it is. Yes. Yeah. The answer is I don't know. I wouldn't
it's
even know.
It's forever
what it would
a
be
mystery.
Like. Yeah.
Let's get her on the show next week.
Find her again.
It's like the season finale of The Bachelor. Will he make her come?
Now listen to your heart.
Listen to your dick.
All right, next question.
Jackson,
what do we
can
got?
We finally get a question, or do you still want to know about how
questions.
Charlie shaves his ass?
Keep him rolling.
No, I want to know about you now, Kaya.
Oh, yeah, wait, Kaya.
It's extremely boring. It's basically the same as Jack... fuck, I keep calling you. Andrew's and Charlie's.
You had an internet girlfriend at the age of 17 and flew a 24-year-old out to have sex at a hotel across the street from your parents' room to a really awkward period phase?
With yes, an anti-period detonation device, electromagnetic detonation pulse device? Generator.
Boy, if I saw any menstrual blood, she was going to blow.
One touch of sperm and she
would
have
exploded. It wasn't a tampon string, it was a fuse.
A dead man switch.
Jackson, real no, quick though.
Actually,
Jackson, hang on. Just while it's happening, Jackson, does it feel like a large man is sitting on your chest?
Yeah, I'm sweating.
Yeah, I don't feel the heat anymore, but I just feel this immense like pressure everywhere in my insides.
Yeah, it's mostly on my stomach.
Oh
I've had
god,
6 jalapenos so far.
You need to have 7, young man. Anyway, Kaya, continue. I'm sorry.
Yeah, your turn.
It wasn't a long distance relationship, but it was like for 1 year, and it was. I think Andrew is gonna agree with me here if I drop some wisdom and say no long distance relationship
yes.
ever works out. Ever.
Yes.
And now it doesn't matter who you are, where you start out.
You
just end up resenting each other.
God,
yeah. I can hear the emotion in your voice. The pepper's really bringing it out.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's, I always take a pepper before I act. It's actually a trade secret in Hollywood. Long story short, I think I fucked her in my sister's house while she was there. My sister.
You fucked your sister?
You fucked your sister in her house while your girlfriend was there?
What a plot twist.
Damn.
That's nothing at all like our story. Exactly.
Was she wearing a mask and then when you were done, she pulled it off like a Scooby-Doo villain? I knew it. And she was like, I would have gotten away with it too if it weren't for those darn kids.
Fortunately not. God bless her, but my sister is, she looks like a man. So no.
Does she look like a ghost haunting an old quarry?
What?
Never mind.
Wait, what?
That's not a reference I get.
I'm rolling with
Scooby-Doo again.
Yeah, I was rolling with the Scooby-Doo theme.
So you like referenced vague season 3 episode 6.
Season 3 episode 17, The Haunted Mineshaft. Where Scooby-Doo and the gang
That's actually part one of a two-parter, so it's not actually episode 17, it's 17B.
That's the one where they meet the Harlem Globetrotters. Why don't you learn your facts?
Oh my god, it's not even anime.
Scooby-Doo's the worst anime of all time.
Scooby-Doo's the worst anything of all time.
Scooby-Doo.
I don't think you watched that.
It's gotten better over time, but the old Scooby-Doos are boring as all fuck.
What are you fucking talking about? Do you still watch Scooby-Doo? You are a fairy,
aren't you? 30 Scooby-Doos.
You're delirious. These are fever dreams.
No, the fever's passed.
Go shove a thermometer up your ass.
I'm going to shove this scotch bonnet up my ass if you don't stop.
Oh, jeez. Don't stop, Kai. Don't make him do it.
What do you have left, Andrew?
Your turn, Jackson.
I have 1.5 green peppers. I don't remember what they're called.
Do it.
And no. And I have a full scotch bonnet.
Chug.
No, okay. Maybe.
Pepper stand.
Maybe I'll
just
think about
funnel
it.
Funnel pepper seeds through a fucking keg.
Give me a bit, and then I'll take another chomp of the lesser scotch or the lesser pepper.
Oh, my stomach hurts.
I don't know if I can do another scotch. That was a lot.
All right, Jackson,
do you have another scotch?
Yeah, he does.
I have another. Yeah, I got another scotch bonnet.
Ooh,
that'll be
stick
the
around, folks.
We're not out of it yet. Come on, Jackson, tell your story now. I'm actually really curious about yours.
I lost my virginity when I was 16. I was in a relationship with this chick for 2 years. And like a year in, I lost my virginity to her because I wanted to wait. I was a righteous young man. I wanted to wait until I was mature enough. So 16 was the age where I popped my cherry, blew my load. But nothing as interesting as long distance relationships or fucking my sister.
Well, was she like 30 years old, like Andrew's girlfriend?
No,
hey,
she's
24. Not that that's much better.
Is there anything interesting? Give us the details.
Yeah.
What position was it?
Tell us the exact moment. Tell us the exact moment you ejaculated.
Yeah, and what were you thinking?
We fucked under the stars. It was like...
Oh, that's romantic.
That is romantic.
So Tom Cruise and Tom Hardy were just watching you from up above?
That's another reference I don't get.
Do you know what a star
They're
is?
They're stars, you mongoloid.
I'm sorry they don't have celebrities in Australia.
I thought he was referencing Scooby-Doo again. I was like, when did Tom Cruise star in Scooby-Doo?
So it's like, hey, Scoob, like it's Tom
Scooby-Doo
Cruise.
Scooby-Doo is Tom Cruise's breakthrough role.
Yeah, watching Scooby fuck Shaggy under the stars.
She was a bit shaggy.
Ooh.
Actually, Jackson, there's a story I want you to tell on this podcast. Tell about that time you were 69ing a girl and then saw like an earthworm poking
out
of her
ass. No. That was a one-time thing, Charlie. That was a one-time thing.
That's such a good story, though.
You belittled me over that.
If anyone wants to actually watch that story, I think it's in our Jackbox stream.
Yeah. Stop advertising for yourself, Andrew.
Why won't you tell the story again? It's a great story.
Because I feel bad now, because you belittled me for not telling her.
Jackson, for real, tell the story and just like leave out an identity, because we still don't know who this girl is.
Yeah, nobody's going to go to fucking Andrew's hitbox.
Good old hitbox.
So essentially, what was happening was we were getting down and dirty, as a young 17-year-old man does.
Now, wait, back up. What was her last name again?
No, shut up. We were 69ing. If you don't know what a 69 is... since I'm sure most of our audience haven't had sex yet.
For all of our kids in the audience.
69 is where...
That's the sixth number.
Where the man's face lays between a woman's lap. It's like, if you imagine the two numbers, like, you'll see...
Why are you explaining this?
You're trying really hard to explain this.
Yeah, you didn't really need to explain it.
Move on.
Alright, so basically the 69 was going down, and so, like, you know, my face was in her vagina, and I was eating it up, you know, and right. Basically what happened was I felt like a tap, 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 like a knocking on my head, and I was in the moment, so it didn't really click with me that, like, I thought it was just, like, pressure sensitivity or something, like I was about to come or whatever, so I ignored it, but then it kept happening, and it started getting, like, a bit faster and a bit harder. And I started taking actual, like, mental note of what was happening. So I look up, and out of her asshole is this fucking tapeworm or something. Some, like, string or something. Oh, some foreign God. Creature.
It was Kaya.
Just knocking.
It was the resident of the ass asking you to keep the noise down.
Hey, I'm trying.
No, you're trying to sleep.
Can you stop banging on my neighbor's door?
Got a hoot out of Charlie.
That was a good one.
So yeah, basically it was just this tapeworm tapping on my head, like, yeah, it was a weird feeling.
That's,
it didn't feel
that's
like
disgusting.
What?
Did it you pull it out beautiful. For her?
No.
Did you bite it? And
I was a
17
year old guy.
Yeah,
I legitimately believe that domestic abuse is wrong, but I would not fault you for beating the shit out of her.
She
if
was,
I was exposed to something that disgusting.
She was a 32 year old woman. You need to do her a favor, dude.
I'm sorry.
Did you tell
it
her?
It was actually, it was Caius. No, I didn't tell her.
It did you poke it back in?
No, I just ignored it and left.
Like, put it back? Well,
you're home. I just made up some excuse.
Like, basically. Oh, I have to go. There's a tapeworm in your ass.
I didn't want to have that conversation with someone.
So
oh,
what?
Oh, yeah, you, that, no. That conversation, the one we've all had with our significant other.
Yeah, really.
Honey, it's time we have the tapeworm.
I didn't want to have to explain to her what a 69 was.
You know, I was eating this girl out, and a fucking foreign creature came out of her butthole, but I just didn't feel right telling her.
I'm sure she found out one way or the
She found out when she looked at her ass and saw Jackson's sticky note that said, I'm sorry I had to leave, but there's a tapeworm in your ass.
I left clues around the house.
You could start by looking in the Valley of the Three Kings.
It just ends with there's a tapeworm in your ass.
That's it.
Fucking
it's like
national
one of those
prize.
Escape room games. You lock her in a room until she can figure it out.
Can you escape the ass tapeworm?
I've hidden a key under your arm.
She uses that key to open a safe, and inside the safe is a ripped sticky note and some chewing gum. Then she puts the chewing gum on the ceiling fan, which makes it stop, and then it reveals Morse code written in lights on the ceiling.
It all leads to like an anti-parasite medication thing.
Finally, it leads her to a phone book that says, call me with your phone number in it, and when she calls you, you say you have a tapeworm in your ass.
You could have been so CDC. Hard. You could have been so fucking hardcore if you just like ripped the tapeworm out mid-69 and just like
fucking hell, hardcore.
Yeah, that would have been fucking dope, man. You would have been like Jack Bauer of tapeworms.
You know, it could have been
an
anal
bead. What if it was like a plug holding back a dam of shit?
An anal bead?
Yeah.
Could have been, for all I know.
Did she put that in there to prep?
No, I don't think so. So that's why I jumped to the conclusion that it's a tapeworm.
She just put a tapeworm in there to get in the mood.
That's how everyone preps.
So you should have been like, babe, do you have anal beads? And she's like, no. And you got to say, well, I have some bad news for you then.
People do. People do digest like tapeworms to get skinny, don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that is she might.
I mean, it works. You're eating for two.
Oh.
It's not that kind of awe, Jackson.
That's cute. I've got a fetish for tapeworms now.
We know.
No, any ladies out there listening?
You're one to talk, Mr. Furry.
Any tapeworms out there listening, if you want to reside in Jackson's fucking stomach, beware, there's some peppers in there. All right, next question. How about that?
Yeah, what's the next question?
So this is a scenario question from Rise Against Fan 13 for Andrew. So
okay.
So Charlie, Jackson, and Kaya all go driving and end up crashing, and none of them survive the crash.
All go driving? Like a walk? Like, let's just drive.
What are you on? No, we're just driving and we crashed.
What's unrealistic about that?
Yeah, yeah. Really. You guys,
no one says let's go for a drive.
Actually, yeah, people do, Kaya.
Just read the question.
I wanted to read the question. You, Andrew, go to the funeral home to make funeral arrangements. The owner of the funeral home comes out and says, "Us here at the funeral home are big fans of your podcast and YouTube videos, so we've decided to give you 3 caskets for free."
This is clearly fantasy then, but please continue.
It's a riddle. Now the 3 caskets...
Then the Sphinx shows up and says, "What walks on 4 legs in the morning?"
Now the 3 caskets presented to you are a beautifully crafted casket, best casket they have to offer, regular casket, normal Melvin casket, and a Nike shoebox they have to chop the deceased person up to fit in it. Now Andrew, who goes in which casket?
I'd put all 3 of you in the shoebox, put wheels on the nice casket, and drift race it to hell.
The nice casket.
Sounds good.
No. Actual answer, if I were to go,
ships are on stake here.
You don't need to weigh the moral repercussions of one or the other. It's a very silly question to can warrant a silly answer here, Andrew. This doesn't need to collapse your
Charlie's
psyche.
Just gonna hang up if he gets the Nike shoebox.
Charlie just doesn't want to be offended.
Going by first reactions, Charlie nice casket, Kaya shoebox, Jackson regular casket, because I feel that's what all 3 of you would want.
I feel like since Charlie's the shortest of us, he should go in the shoebox.
They don't even have to chop him up. Just get a size 14. He'll squat. He'll fit.
Did Charlie hang up?
I'm done. I'm walking away. And I'm taking my VidMe sponsorship with me.
All right, next question.
X Lepraz asks,
I'm not sponsored by VidMe. That's a joke. The official podcast is brought to you by VidMe to get Kai out of Turkey.
Stop saying Turkey.
Christmas Island.
Question Fufflenum asks, who is the gayest of the 4 of you?
That's a good question.
Yeah.
For real?
I mean, it's better than which Minecraft block would you be?
Which is not a good question. What in your opinion is the gayest Minecraft block?
I always use the Minecraft block as my baseline for the worst question that could be asked and just compare it to that and see how it stands.
Yeah, it's like, what Minecraft block would Jesus do?
Here we go. FryFox12 asks, you have been hired by a major university to teach an absolutely bizarre subject. What is your subject called, and how would you describe the course and rules? What would your professor name be? Well, you could do something with that.
Absolutely bizarre.
Yeah, I've had a really good scam in my head for a long time, which would be animal psychology, where I'd kind of like open up a little animal psychiatric ward and people would bring in, you know...
That exists.
No, not in this
capacity.
It's
called Dr. Doolittle, you shitlord.
But he can actually talk to animals. That's a good point. I wouldn't be able to. I'd just kind of play with the dog for like 3 hours and be like, yeah, Buster, just, you know, he's not feeling himself. You need to bring him back for another like $100, $200, something reasonable. And I could have a degree in it.
What if they bring you a cat?
Oh, then they'd need to get out.
The joke is Charlie hates cats.
Oh, boy.
Andrew, what would your course be at this university, a shitty course that you would teach? How to not be able
Surviving
to handle
peppers
like a man?
How to ask good questions, because obviously we need it.
Yeah.
No.
We don't need it.
I would probably teach...
Ask a good question, Charlie, because I legitimately need one.
I feel like Sam. I thought about this at one point, actually. I wanted to do a course on, like, the... I don't know. I can't really think of it or word it.
Wow, what a huge build-up for such an underwhelming reveal.
Yeah, man. It's a good thing we're not leaving this in anyway.
What's
I want this to be left in.
No.
I want everyone to... I want you to wallow in your shame. I want people to see that.
I already wallowed in my shame when I ate that fucking pepper.
That's true.
Eat another pepper. We need energies to skyrocket again.
No.
I don't want to.
It still hurts.
I'll eat one. I don't give a fuck, Jackson. You want to eat a pepper?
Yeah, I've already...
Yeah, because your peppers are nothing, Charlie.
Oh, excuse me. I didn't buy the fucking chunks of lava from the fucking black market like you did, Andrew. Sorry.
Why it got to be the black market? All right, so a lot of like would you rather's out there are really bad and cringeworthy and terrible and like look at this thing. This is one that I think is actually interesting, and I thought of it. Okay, would you rather And you have to go through this to completion.
Yeah.
Teach a gorilla to jerk you off, or jerk off a gorilla.
Teach a gorilla to jerk you off.
Hey, hang on.
What, that's a terrible
think
question.
Think what that entails. You have
How
to make sure
it entails
that
gorillas
question.
Are smart.
Because think about it. You have to get close to the gorilla without it beating your ass. You have to win the
gorillas
gorilla's trust.
We teach gorillas.
I know, but you have to do this yourself. You have to put in the time and the effort.
So what, I find a wild gorilla and then I just say,
yes.
Yep, that's the one that's going
to
jerk
me
off?
Yes, you are given a wild gorilla, never exposed to man, and you have to teach it one of those two things from start to finish. You either have to get it to let you jerk it off, or teach it to delicately and nicely handle your junk to jerk you off. To completion,
I'd jerk it off.
I'd also jerk it off.
Could I?
Gorillas are fucking strong, they'll rip your dick off.
But do you think that
also,
you could teach
they have, they're intelligent, like they know how to use pressure in their hands.
Yeah.
I feel like you could teach them.
See, Kaya's on the other side.
If you took the peel off of a banana and wrapped it around your dick and pretended you were just unwrapping a banana.
Then they try to eat your fucking dick.
What about
dick?
The three times before you teach it where it rips your dick off?
Yeah.
Well, what about the three times before you try to jerk
it
off where
it
just
kills you? It's like
you
guys didn't even... Did you not even watch the South Park episode where Cartman teaches a horse to eat a dick?
Well, no, look. Here's the other thing you have to consider. How harder is it to get a gorilla to let you touch its dick as opposed to getting a gorilla to just touch your dick?
Not hard if you euthanize it.
Okay, then you can't jerk it off because it can't get an erection. You've foiled yourself.
You don't
euthanize
it. Have you tested that hypothesis?
Yeah.
How the fuck do you get an erection without testicles?
Euthanize, as in...
Oh, I thought you... Oh, euthanize. Oh, I was thinking of...
De-sex it?
What's the...
Neuter. Jackson,
neutered. I was thinking of neutered it. Yeah, neutering. My bad. I was thinking of neutering.
Well, all right. Just put it, like, just
you
knock
can't,
it out.
You can't kill the gorilla. That's cheating.
All right, bull tranquilizer.
Tranquilizing
like
is
I said,
what you mean. No,
to completion.
That's not part of the question, Jackson. You don't get to cheat. It has to be fully alert and furious.
Why is it mad now?
As I said in the question, the gorilla has to let you jerk it off. If it's dead, it's not consenting.
I would argue the opposite.
Oh, fuck off, Charlie. That I know what your girlfriends are like then.
Dead bedroom.
Now we know why your sex is so lackluster.
No one ever said that.
Oh.
It's just
that's
corpses.
Just you. Assuming.
Oh. Assuming. It makes an ass out of you and me.
Ugh. How dare you assume he has sex with corpses?
So Charlie, you would jerk it off. Jackson, you would jerk it off. Kaya, I'm assuming
I would still jerk it off.
You would let it. You would try to teach it to jerk you off.
Yes, I would teach it our ways. Create
the
peace
first bastion
between
of man. The first pillar of man is jerking yourself off.
Just extend the branch of peace or whatever.
There's zookeepers out there that do jerk off animals like for a job, so I feel like that's more normal than getting jerked off by an animal.
Well, yes, but zookeepers, that's what I said at the beginning. If you're talking about a gorilla in the zoo, I can just walk up to it and have it jack me off.
How much do you have to pay for that pass? Where can where can I get that one?
The question isn't raining on the whole like, oh, jerk it off a gorilla, duh. It's the idea of the time, effort, and feasibility of it. Like, you're starting from square one with this gorilla. It has not seen people. It does not know you. You have to teach it from start to finish to either jerk you off or let you jerk it off.
Why do you put this would you rather question you've come up with on such a high ethical pedestal? You're like, you see, you're hung up on jerking off a gorilla. Ho, but think about
there's
this.
Deeper issues, Charlie. Just because you don't understand this course.
Seriously. All right, that's it. My university course is going to be teaching how to jerk off gorillas. From square one.
I thought it was going to be understanding would you rather questions.
Because, Charlie, the whole point of would you rathers is the ethical dilemma.
Of course.
If you make would you rathers just for would you rather fuck a butt or get fucked in the butt, then it's not fun.
Charlie and I are still thinking of the ethical dilemmas, though. We'd still think it's more acceptable to be jerked off. I mean, to jerk off the gorilla.
See, you're having trouble already.
It's getting mixed in my head. Alright.
He just wants to jerk off, guys.
Jackson admitting his bias.
Yeah, really. Jackson's the furry now.
Jackson just admit. Ooh. Oh, is this where that question comes from, Andrew? Andrew, you can just admit it. You don't have to, like, dance around the topic here with weird fucking ethical questions.
Kaya and I were talking about last night. If you were a furry, we'd still accept
yeah,
you.
Yeah, Andrew, nobody knows Fur Affinity unless they've at least searched Google for furry porn.
Okay. I'm genuinely confused.
Have you searched furry porn?
No, Kaya, you linked Fur Affinity last night.
Oh, yeah, of course I did.
Yeah, you're the one who did it. Week. Go through the chat logs. Looks like you have something to say.
No, Andrew, you mentioned it last week in the fucking podcast.
I did? I genuinely do not remember that.
That lost jalapeno really giving me the wet work over here.
See, Charlie's used to it now. Charlie, I'm gonna mail you Charlie. The scotch bonnet.
Charlie, if I said I was gonna pay you like $50,000, would you try and feed a wild gorilla just a hot pepper?
Bro, I'd do that just for YouTube views.
That's it.
Thanks for tuning in. I'm about to prank this gorilla. He thinks he's getting a banana. Nope, it's a California Reaper in a banana peel.
That would be fucking great.
That would be mad.
God dude, that damn. Would be nuts. Remember to smash the like button for more pranks against innocent animals.
Remember to smash the like button as this gorilla smashes Charlie, my spinal yeah. cord.
Remember those stupid pranks we were thinking of?
Yeah.
That we were gonna, we should tell that story.
Yeah,
since
tell,
this is winded down. We're,
yeah.
Okay, so basically, Charlie and I were talking about all those shitty fake prank channels, and we thought we had this idea of we should prank YouTubers by inviting them into Skype calls and telling them about just super unethical pranks that we wanna do and then have them react, basically. And our idea, like, Charlie, who was the first? Well, not first, but like the only person we invited into a call and talked to.
Oh, the I hate everything guy.
Can we mention it?
Yeah.
He's a cool dude. Is he okay with it?
I don't know.
Okay.
Well, I don't know if he's okay
I don't
with
know.
It.
I mean, maybe he doesn't want to be associated with Gorilla Jerking.
Well, I mean...
Maybe he's high class.
That's a good point. I don't know.
The pranks... Huh?
He might not want to be associated with the official podcast. Oh, God damn it. They mentioned
his
me on
loss.
The official podcast? Fuck. Gotta change my name.
Subs just
bro, better be careful. You know, we got three podcasts on our kill list, on our body count. So make it four.
I still can't believe that shit.
I don't know why that was such a big deal.
It really isn't. People made it a big deal because they assumed that we actually had some association with any of that.
I think the fun way to tell the story would be to pretend we're telling it to Andrew. What do you think, Charlie?
I think the fun way to tell it is not to say what we did, but what our idea was, where we would take the concept of these fake prankster YouTubers, except take it to the extreme, where we'd, like, Kaya's had two really brilliant pranks, where I would distract, like, a mother with her child.
Okay, here's prank number one, because I don't remember the second one exactly, so you can tell that I remember the first. Is we go into a coffee shop, Charlie and me and someone filming. Since Charlie is, you know, kind of a cute boy, he's going to distract. We're going to find a single mom, right? With a baby, a toddler, just maybe she's, you know, just sitting there with the baby. And Charlie's going to distract her. He's going to go like, hey, ma'am. And she's going to be like, who said that? And Charlie's going to be like, look down. And she's going to be like, oh, hi. And I'm going to sneak up behind her, take the baby's pacifier out, and replace it with a hot pepper. That was prank one.
Holy
yeah,
fuck.
Basically.
It's a doozy.
That's fucked.
That was a solid
no.
solid
well,
one.
I like that when we told this to the I hate whatever guy, for like 10 minutes we argued about the moral dilemma. And I was genuinely trying to pass this off as, well, what's wrong with it?
Yeah. And then Kaya, and the second prank Kaya had where we would take two homeless men and have them do a chess battle against each other for like a lump sum of cash, but the catch is the chess pieces are made out of soap, so we'd walk by and just spray water on the board and nobody wins. And then we
oh,
say,
was that it? I yeah. remember that far more vicious.
If you
like, I remember
you beat them to death as well.
No, something like that. Like, we're gonna get a homeless guy, we're gonna promise him food if he wins at chess. Right? And then we're going to play chess with him. If he loses, we're not going to do anything. We're just going to point at him and laugh. But if he's close to winning, right before he touches that last piece and calls checkmate, we're going to have him sit on the, you know, he'll be sitting on this shitty chair and we're just going to kick the leg from out under him. He's going to fall backwards. And then we're just going to, you know, throw some fucking dough and water on him. Or just some powder. I don't
remember that at all. I just remember the soap chess pieces. I thought that was really entertaining.
I just remember us saying we were going to hurt homeless people.
God damn.
The idea was just to, as a joke, making fun of the YouTube pranksters, and Kyle wanted to pitch these ideas to YouTube pranksters to see what they thought of it.
You could actually, you could do something with that, where you could do, like, a show where you coordinate this stuff, and you set up these pranks gone wrong and actually do them. Like, imagine, as, like, a prank, you get... The whole point is you go, you see that guy on that bench, we're gonna set him on fire. But he's actually like an actor you hire wearing a burn suit. So you bring in like the YouTubers to react to it, and like you tell them, all right, man, you see that guy sitting on the bench? We're gonna glue his newspaper shut. But then you run over and set him on fire and see how the people watching react.
That's like wicked discrimination right there. You don't mess with homeless people's newspaper, dude. It's a hate crime. That's his house.
I think that's a genuinely good idea.
Well, he didn't even pay the mortgage on that.
He had two payments left.
Like, cover a guy in squibs and just walk over and be like, epic prank, and then you shoot a guy and murder him in front of the people reacting.
Andrew, do you know What Would You Do?
If I were on that prank show?
No, there is a show called What Would You Do?
Oh, yeah, that is exactly this,
where they, like... They'll have two actors, and one will be like a black person, and the other will just, or maybe he'll be a Muslim or something. The other one will be acting as a neo-Nazi, and he'll be just punch the guy and call him a dirty Mazi terrorist, and then they'll just keep the camera on all the actual people and see what they do.
Yeah,
but
I've seen that.
It wasn't so great because they didn't do any cool pranks. Like they didn't. I don't know. I feel like we could top that shit.
What would YouTube pranksters do?
Is that an existential quandary, or are you asking us?
It's a would you rather.
It was more of a pitch for a show idea.
What Minecraft block did they be?
But yeah, that was that.
Well, next topic. Here we go. What else?
Should have thought of topics before.
What else did I write down? Oh, okay, here's the thing I wrote down as something to leap off of. What's something weird that you do when you're alone?
I dance every time I eat food. Like when I'm alone, I usually bust a few moves.
Fruit? Why fruit?
Like how hard of moves? Are we talking just like regular dancing or really getting into it?
I don't know. Like the old Bernie, and sometimes I'll do like arm and body waves.
But why when you eat fruit though?
No, I said food.
Food.
Oh, food. Yeah. Okay. No, well, still why?
I don't know. Just,
is it some ritual thanking the gods?
It's just something I've done for a long time. I don't know why. Anyone else dance when they eat food, or I don't know, jerk off gorillas or something?
That's not too weird.
Kyle, what about you?
Think. No, I can't think of anything.
Jackson,
every time I spill a drink, I say that quote from Airline. Even if I'm alone.
Which one?
I've got a drinking problem. I've got a drinking problem.
You just say it to yourself and giggle.
Yeah, I do. It is almost like I feel bad if I don't say it, so I say it like 2 minutes after the fact. Like just really sad, like, all right. I've got a drinking problem.
Jackson the lone wolf here.
I'm always alone.
Kind of bounding off of that one, I talk to myself constantly. Like fucking, not even like muttering or anything. Like the main one I do is I yell at things. So,
me too.
So, let's say I go, I'm alone, and I like go to my kitchen and make a sandwich. I don't do it all the time, but a good amount. Like, I'll be like, all right, sandwich, and just like take it, and no one will be around.
You insult it too.
Do you do
autistic screeching?
No, I just yell at shit, and I have no reason to.
Do you do autistic screeching, Kaya?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if that qualifies. I don't know if there's some handbook where I have to meet the requirements, but I just make dumb sounds. I probably do have some problems. Like when I hear a noise, I imitate it. I don't know why.
You're part cockatoo.
Sometimes when I hear a joke I really like, I just repeat it to myself afterwards. Sometimes.
Even if do you pretend like you were the one saying it?
Yeah. Like if someone's like, and add some bacon, and it's like really funny, I'll, for I don't know, maybe a couple minutes after, just be doing stuff, and I'll be like, and I'll add some bacon.
But you're in a social circle and everyone applauds you.
Yeah, they're all like, I got that reference, ha ha ha.
I also talk to shit sometimes too.
Yeah, it's not that weird.
I think that's too weird.
Some dude at my college was given like this psych lesson, and it was on It was one of those like things you don't realize that everyone does. It was one of those like kind of not pep rally, but one of those like, hey, you can feel good about yourself kind of like lectures. You know what I mean? Because it was freshman orientation stuff.
Talk to things.
No. And he said, every single person in this room talks to themselves. And he said, if you say to yourself, well, I don't do that, who are you talking to?
Uh-huh.
And that's not exactly checkmate. I don't think anyone would say that out loud.
No, it's not, but it got me thinking about the idea of it.
We literally just call that thinking.
Yeah, Jesus Christ,
thinking
Andrew.
Out loud.
Being conscious.
Oh, excuse me for having fun. God, fucking Debbie Downers, all of you. Jesus, fuck.
God forbid we weren't cornered by that fucking brick
wall of logic.
God forbid
you learned to smile.
Yeah.
Oh, what a zinger. I'm sorry, Andrew. That was fun. Brilliant.
I mean, I'm not really attached to this.
Do you know the name of that person? Does he or she have a TED talk?
Probably Rip Deepak Smiley Chopra. Or something. I don't know.
Deepak Charlie?
Chopra. What? I said Deepak Chopra.
Who is that?
You don't know Deepak Chopra? He's basically a grown-up Willow Smith. Or whatever his name
Jaden
is.
Jaden Smith?
Yeah, whatever.
Deepak Chopra.
They both look like their dad. It really doesn't matter. They both look like mini wolves.
I just Googled this as hard as I could. Oh my god, this guy is weird.
Andrew, he's a scam artist, like new age nonsense guy who just tweets shit that basically sounds indistinguishable from what a generator gives you.
Wow. This fucking guy. All right, let's get a good wrap up.
Yeah, all right. Thank you guys for watching this spicy episode of the official podcast.
Ooh.
We're on SoundCloud, we're on iTunes, we're on YouTube right here, and of course, we're on VidMe. Go check us out on VidMe. It's the official podcast. We'll leave a link in the description directly to the VidMe account so you can watch our videos there as well. Yes, thanks for watching. Check out the subreddit.
Praise Jesus.
Thanks for listening.
Well, goodbye, everyone.